This week on The Wire, nation faces record rent hike, loan deferrals drop again, and pandemic boosts ownership desire. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest, and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment, and more. Now please like, comment, and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So our top story for this week, nation faces record rent hike. So the next several years will produce the biggest increase in rents that Australia has seen, and that's according to real estate analyst, I should say, Simon Presley. Presley, who is Propertyology's head of research, is forecasting 2021 and beyond will see record increases in rents thanks to a housing shortage. Now, with house price growth expected to reach up to 15%, Presley says many locations could see rents rise by $2,000 to $5,000 per annum. He says the reality is that Australia does not have enough housing supply for its population. 5 out of 8 capital cities, plus many regional centres, have vacancy rates below 1%. Now, while Sydney and Melbourne have a surplus of rental stock and are witnessing declining rents, other locations across Australia tell a very different story. Now, Sydney and Melbourne's combined population of 10.5 million people have just over 50,000 dwellings for rent to choose from, while the remaining 15 million Australians who live in smaller capital cities and regional areas have only the choice of 20,000 dwellings. Now, guys, for our next story, loan deferrals drop again. So new figures show that households and small to medium enterprises are steadily moving back to making repayments on their loans after using pandemic emergency measures to defer them. Now, the Australian Prudential Regulation Authority says only 2.3% of housing and small to medium business loans were subject to repayment deferrals at the end of November. Now, at the height of the pandemic crisis, the figure was over 10%. Deferrals peaked in May at more than 12% of all housing loans, but stood at only 2.8% by the end of November. Now, what seems even more remarkable is the small to medium enterprise loans. In May, SME deferrals peaked at 17.5% of all loans, but have improved markedly since September to only 2.4% by the end of November. Now, those figures were accompanied by a jump in housing approvals also since June of 40%, with total approvals at over 17,000 in November and figures for the year totaling almost 170,000. Now, independent economist Saul Eastlake says, who would have thought just a few months ago that we would have seen figures at such a low level? Now, guys, for our final story of the week, pandemic boosts ownership desire. So the pandemic has accelerated the desire for home ownership in young people, and that is according to Mortgage Choice Research. Nearly 45% of survey respondents are more likely to purchase a home now, with a similar number feeling optimistic about achieving their home ownership goals. The research suggests that the pandemic has caused a shift in priorities, with saving money now rated as the highest priority for young people. In order to save and buy sooner, 60% are reducing their spending, 58% adding more to their savings accounts, and 43% are applying for government grants for first home buyers. Mortgage Choice Chief Executive Officer Susan Mitchell says the pandemic provided a wake-up call, and for young people, this meant focusing their attention on their financial goals. She says, despite the challenges of getting into the property market, young people are not giving up on the great Australian dream. In times of uncertainty, it's human nature to want stability, and this is what investing in property can provide. Well, guys, they're the top stories for this week. Now, please don't forget to comment, like, and share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, guys, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that is action. Thanks a lot, and bye for now.